Now it's time to learn how to write the names and formulas for ionic compounds that contain transition elements. These are only slightly different from the compounds you've been working with up until now. Recall that the transition elements are the metals located in groups 3 through 12 of the periodic table. As metals, they can achieve stability by giving up electrons to form positively charged ions. Unlike the other groups of the periodic table, some transition metals can form more than one type of positive ion. In other words, transition metals can have more than one oxidation number, also called an oxidation state. This is also true for some of the metals located just beneath the metalloids on the periodic table. For example, copper can form an ion with a positive 1 charge, or an ion with a positive 2 charge. As you can see in these pictures, these two different ions can form ionic compounds that differ slightly in their properties. Iron is another example because it can achieve stability and have a stable ion with a plus 2 oxidation number or a plus 3 oxidation number. Not all transition metals have multiple oxidation states. These transition metals, zinc, silver, nickel, and cadmium, only have one form of their ions. This is important because it means their name just like any other monatomic ion. The Zn plus 2 is called zinc ion, for instance. Because this one seems to confuse some students, I should also point out that aluminum is a group 13 metal. It's not a transition metal. It only has one possible charge, and that's plus 3. So what if you have the formula of an ionic compound with a transition element in it? How do you write the compound's name? Well, first you write the cation's name. In order to distinguish between the names of transition metal ions that can have more than one charge, you must use a capital Roman numeral to represent the amount of positive charge. For example, the copper ion with a positive 1 charge is called copper 1, whereas the copper ion with a positive 2 charge is called copper 2. After writing the cation's name, then you write the anion's name, just as you would for any ionic compound. Here's a list of some commonly used positively charged ions. The ones highlighted in blue include aluminum and those transition metals that form only one ion, as I talked about earlier. The metals highlighted in yellow all have multiple oxidation states, and the lines are included to illustrate that point. Notice that mercury forms two different ions with a positive 2 charge. The name for mercury 2 makes sense because it's a mercury ion with a positive 2 charge. Be careful with mercury 1, though. The mercury 1 ion is actually a polyatomic ion in which two mercury atoms are bonded together with an overall charge of positive 2. Since each mercury atom in this polyatomic ion can hold one of the two charges, it's called mercury 1 to differentiate it from mercury 2. Mercury 2 is only one mercury atom that has lost two electrons to form the positive 2 cation. Mercury is unique in this way, but don't worry, the charges of the other transition metals are easily enough identified through their Roman numerals. Let's practice a few. CuCl has a 1-to-1 ratio of cation to anion. Chloride has a charge of -1 because it's a group 17 nonmetal with 7 valence electrons. If only one copper ion is needed to balance the -1 charge, we can infer that the copper ion has to have a charge of +1. It must then be called copper 1 chloride. Using similar logic, we can figure out which copper ion is present in CuCl2. Two negative 1 ions are needed to balance out the one positive 2 ion. So the copper ion must be copper 2. So this compound is copper 2 chloride. What do you think FeSO4 is called? Remember that SO4 is a polyatomic ion, and think about its charge. If you remembered that SO4 is sulfate and that it has a -2 charge, then the one iron ion needed to balance its charge must have a charge of +2. FeSO4 is iron 2 sulfate. Use this information, this process, to determine which iron ion is present in this last formula and figure out its name. Since three negative 2 sulfate ions are present, the total negative charge is a total of negative 6, meaning the total positive charge has to be positive 6. With two positive ions, they must each therefore be positive 3. So this compound is iron 3 sulfate. Even though these two compounds are both formed from iron and sulfate, they're two different compounds. Iron 2 sulfate is blue-green and used as a food supplement and fertilizer. Iron 3 sulfate is yellow and it's used in sewage treatment processes. Even though they're formed from the same elements, because they're present in different ratios, these elements form different compounds. What's the name of ZnO? Because zinc only has one oxidation state, no Roman numeral is necessary. This compound is zinc oxide. Don't call it zinc 2 oxide, because that would be incorrect. Remember not to use Roman numerals except for elements with multiple oxidation states. What about the next one, CrO? CrO is chromium 2 oxide, because oxygen forms a negative 2 ion. What about Cr2O3? Cr2O3 is chromium 3 oxide. Remember that the Roman numeral refers to the charge of the metal, not to the number of metal ions in the formula. What's the name of CrO3? CrO3 is a negative 6 total charge, balanced by a positive 6 total charge. So this chromium ion has a plus 6 charge. The compound is chromium 6 oxide. What about going the other direction? How do you write the formula of an ionic compound that has a transition metal in it if you're given the name? Well, just follow the rules for naming any ionic compound. First, write the symbol of the cation, then write the symbol of the anion. Use subscripts and parentheses if necessary to cancel out the total positive and negative charge to make the compound neutral. The Roman numeral will help you determine the charge of the metal ion if it's one of the metals that has multiple oxidation numbers. Let's do some sample formula writing together for practice. Let's look at copper 1 sulfite. Copper 1. Well, copper has the symbol Cu. Copper 1, with the Roman numeral 1, that 1 must refer to a positive 1 charge. Sulfite is SO3. Sulfite is SO3. Sulfate is SO4. SO3 and sulfite have a charge of negative 2. As we can see, we don't have enough positive charge, so we need another copper ion. Now the total positive charge is equal to the total negative charge, so the formula for copper 1 sulfite is Cu2SO3. Notice that the 1, again, refers to the oxidation number of the copper, not to the number of coppers in the formula. 10-4 fluoride. 10 has the symbol Sn. 10 has multiple oxidation states. This one is 4, positive. Fluoride. Well, fluorine is a group 17 metal with 7 valence electrons, so it has a negative 1 charge, just like everything else in group 17. We don't have enough negative charge here. What we need are 4 total fluorides. So the formula then would be Sn, and its positive 4 charge, F4. The 4 negative 1 charges exactly balance out and cancel the 1 positive 4 charge. Gold 3 cyanide. Gold symbol is Au, and with the Roman numeral 3, this must have a positive 3 charge. Cyanide is a polyatomic ion, Cn. It's a carbon and a nitrogen, and they've got a charge of negative 1 overall. So I need 3 negative 1 charges to balance the 1 positive 3 charge. So the formula for gold 3 cyanide would simply be Au, Cn, not Cn3, but I got to put parentheses around the CN, then the 3. If I wrote AUCN3 like this, well, I don't have 3 cyanides then. I have 3 nitrogens and only 1 carbon. So the correct formula would be AU, open parentheses, CN, close parentheses, 3. How about lead 2 sulfide? Well, lead 2 has a lead ion in it, positive 2. Sulfide. Sulfide refers to the sulfur ion. Sulfur is in group 16, like oxygen, and so it has 6 valence electrons. It gains 2 to form sulfide with a negative 2 charge. As we can see here, we have exactly enough positive charge to balance the negative charge, so the formula for lead 2 sulfide would be PbS. Be sure to review this video and the appropriate pages in your notes or textbook if you have trouble writing the names and formulas for ionic compounds with transition metals in them. You can also leave a comment below on the YouTube video page. Thanks for your hard work.